Guys, thanks for coming back. Today we're going to talk about the do's and don'ts of the upcoming school year. I hope you enjoy this video. So you gotta definitely avoid racial slurs. These are never okay. So if you ever feel the need to use one, don't. Not everyone is the same, so not everyone is going to be okay with you using racial slurs. So the best way to know if you can use it or not is just to not use it and not try to use it ever, because it's never okay. Next thing, don't assume anything. The worst thing you can do is to assume something about someone that is false. Let me tell you a story about something that happened to me last year. This girl, she starts talking about her little brother and how he wanted to be a rapper or whatever, and he had that little phase and he was dressing in rapper clothing. And then she says, yeah, you know how he was acting hood. I mean, black, you know? And I was like, I don't know. I didn't understand what she was trying to say, but at the same time, I understood what she was trying to say. Look, it's never okay to assume something about a person or to generalize someone's race. You risk insulting someone and also making yourself sound ignorant. So the best thing to do is to not assume at all and to just ask questions and get involved and educate yourself on other people and other cultures. So how about some do's? Do talk to new people. Look, you never know who's going to be your best friend. The person you were judging all year might be the only person who really understands your situation in life and really understands how you feel. And that guy that you've been avoiding because you think it's gross, he might actually have some nasal issues that he can't help and he needs to get boogers out right away. You never know. So basically the thing about this is that you have to be bold and confident and ready to meet new people, not afraid to walk up to someone, introduce yourself, start a conversation, and just progress with that relationship. You can't be afraid to start things on your own. So yeah, sorry about the change, but let's get to another do. Do be yourself. Never try to be anyone else, because that act gets old pretty fast. What I mean is, it's hard to be the person that you weren't born to be. So you're basically making it up as you go along. So in this case, the easiest option is the best option, and that one would be to just be yourself and to make your own choices and to be the person that you want to be and be the person that you are and work on yourself and build yourself to be a positive figure. So here's a do and a don't. It's the whole teacher's pet thing. When is it okay and when is it not okay? It's okay when you're really struggling in a class and this teacher is hard and they're hard on you, so you need some extra help. You need them to give you some slack. So the best thing to do is to go to the teacher during lunch to get extra help. Go to the teacher in the mornings when they get in, because normally teachers, they come in at like 7:15, maybe 7:30. You go to them in the morning, and our teachers are required to stay after school until 2:30 because we get out at 2:02 exactly. I know that's stupid, but we get out at 2:02 exactly, and they have to stay till 2:30. So you could also go to them right after school, stay with them to get whatever time like they have for you so that you can really understand the material. You can also raise your hand in class, really get involved, and those participation points can really help you. And they're not just there, they're not just something that's like a throwaway point and they don't help you at all, but they do. You raise your hand in class, you ask questions, you sit at the front of the class. I know people don't like to sit at the front of the class, but you better sit in front of the class if you want to get an A. Even if you want to get a C, you better sit in the front of the class. When not to is when you are a straight A plus student and you understand everything that the teacher is saying and you just keep asking questions for no reason. The light went out. Hold on. Got it. Okay. But yeah, you understand everything that the teacher is saying and you're just wasting the teacher's time with cookies and extra laughing and play time for you when you have an A plus. That's when it's not okay, because there are other people in the class that don't understand what's going on and you're just using up the teacher's time, you're using up the class period, you're using up the extra time that the teachers have in lunch and in the morning and in the afternoon when you don't actually need it. If you truly understand the things that are being taught, then I don't see a reason for you to go for any extra help and you have an A plus. If you really think that you need some extra help or some extra study time, a great way to help you in whatever course it is to tutor other people. Like if you have an A plus, B plus, like you can tutor other people, and that's also helping you because you're confirming that you know what you're doing, and that's a great study method also. And there's one more do and don't. So do try new things. Like this is your last year, or even if it's your first year, if you're a freshman, try new things. Like you need to figure out, well, we're still in summer, so you should figure out what it is you want to do either for your last year or to start off your year, and what you want to do for the rest of your high school experience. Because when you get to senior year, you're gonna realize that you didn't exactly do everything you wanted to do, or maybe you did, but you should figure out what you want to do and then try it so that you know, and that you have that fulfillment by the end of your year, and like you don't feel like you didn't do everything that you wanted to do, or that you're leaving without having completed really your high school year the way you wanted to. For me, I'm doing volleyball. Tryouts are on Mondays. I just started learning what I was supposed to do last week. Let me just throw in this don't, because I just said that. Don't procrastinate, because it's a terrible idea. And then when it comes up, when it's like right around the corner, you're gonna feel like you are not prepared. So here's the downside to doing new things and a bunch of new things. You don't want to get overwhelmed with the amount of work that you're doing. I'm gonna tell you now that it's difficult to be in theater, choir, track, you're doing your schoolwork with AP classes and AP class work and whatever else. If you're in the Remnant, that's a club after school, right after school, every Friday. So if you're going into practice, then practice usually starts at 2:30. So you're going to have 30 minutes to be in that club before you have to go to practice, or you're going to be late to practice. And it's really stressful. And then practice gets out probably at like 4:30, 5 o'clock. And then by the time you get home, you're going to be tired. And then you have that AP work. Hey, AP work. Just don't take on too much work and overwhelm yourself and stress yourself out. Because high school, it's tougher than it seems if you have too much going on. So it's better to make a schedule and balance everything out. And that's it for this show, guys. Thanks for watching. Comment and like it and subscribe, please. I'm Amari, and I hope you come back.